Minutes, but first, final look at our top stories. Here once again is Lynn White. Morning, Lynn.
Good morning, Jim, and good morning, everyone. Hugh O'Connor, the son of actor Carol O'Connor, took his own life last night at his home in Los Angeles. His father says he had a real history of drug abuse. Ex-champ and now ex-con Mike Tyson plans to hold a news conference in Cleveland tomorrow. He plans to read a statement, but won't answer any questions. Word is he may dump Don King as his promoter. King won't be at the news conference. The Baseball Players Union is working on a counteroffer to the owner's latest proposal. Union Chief Donald Fehr wasn't bowled over by the offer. On the ice, the Islanders lost to Pittsburgh 6-3. Tonight, the Knicks play in Detroit, the Devils skate in Ottawa, and Virginia Tech plays Marquette for the NIT title at the Garden. Finally, Donald and Ivana are back together again, at least in a commercial. Believe it or not, they're hawking pizza. Reports say Pizza Hut paid Donald and Ivana $1 million each, and both donated their earnings to charity. The commercial begins airing nationally on Saturday. That's going to do it from the news desk. Back over to Jim. He's got more.
Ivana Pizza.
Yeah.
Let's see what's happening on the roads. Here's Kendra. But first, a look at our top stories. Here's Lynn White. Morning, Lynn.
Good morning, Jim, and good morning, everyone. There's word just in from Albany this morning that a budget deal is now in the works. That despite the war of words that's been going on between Senate Majority Leader Joseph Bruno and Assembly Speaker Sheldon Silver. Silver now says a framework for an agreement is just about set. The budget is already 10 days late. Police continue to question a suspect this morning in an attempted mob hit outside Lenox Hill Hospital. It happened last April 26th. On the scoreboard last night, the Devils lost to Montreal 2-1. Tonight, the Islanders skate in Tampa. The Knicks are at home against Miami. Finally, it seems just about everybody who's anybody in Hollywood has had a facelift. And now that includes Tinseltown's famous symbol. The Hilltop Hollywood sign is 72 years old and really looks it. Workers will brighten up the 55-foot letters with a dazzling new paint job, but first they have to scrape off about 40 coats of old paint. That's going to do it from the news desk. Back over to Jim. Here's Gavin Martin.
All right, Lynn, thank you. Another check on the roads.